Welcome back to another video. Today's topic is why you're running out of breath when it comes to swimming. I get this question so many times from my students. Justin, help me. I'm running out of breath as I swim. I can't swim more than one lap. I can't swim more than two laps. How do I get over this hump, Justin? Ugh. And I always give them the same answer every time. And I'm gonna give you this answer to you guys in this video. If you're struggling with doing lap swimming or long distance swimming, I know what the problem is. Yes, your technique is the first thing you need to look at. If you're not comfortable in the water, if you just started swimming for like 2 weeks, you're gonna need some time. Your body's gonna need some time to get used to being in a foreign environment where your body is placed in a horizontal position looking downwards, and you're rowing with your arms and you're kicking blindly and you're looking downwards and your head is going this way. Of course your body needs time to adapt to all of that, okay? So if you're just started, if you're a newbie to swimming, give it some time. Give it at least 3 to 4 months worth of non-stop swimming sessions, 3 to 5 times a week, 1 hour each session minimum. If you can do that for 3 to 5 months, then we can talk. If you're used to your technique now and you know how to move your arms and your legs and your breathing, but the problem is they haven't done any of the other work that's involved. And what am I talking about? I'm talking about your diet. I'm talking about the training that you do outside of the pool. These are two aspects that a lot of swimmers neglect when it comes to becoming a better swimmer. You can tell that I do weight training. You can tell that I do other forms of exercise. Now, what are these exercises that I do? Well, I run and I lift weights a lot. And I do that outside of the pool. So I go to the gym and I run outside. A lot of swimmers I see at the pool are pretty fat, pretty overweight, and they've never stepped foot in a gym before. If you're one of these swimmers, I feel for you, because all you think about is swimming, 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 but swimming is just one component in the complete triangle of training, all right? I would say that if you want to be a more well-rounded swimmer, you're going to have to lift weights and you're going to have to do some form of dry land cardio, whether it's jumping rope, rowing, bicycling, or running outside. Or else, how are you going to develop your stamina when it comes to being in the water? Your system is tackling water and rowing at the same time, blindly. The only thing you can do is strengthen it. We call it a VO2 max, the amount of oxygen your body can intake. If your VO2 max, if you're a beginner, it's gonna be pretty small. You can only take so much air. So you're gonna develop that chamber inside of you, right? And the only way you can do that is by pushing it against itself using cardio. And what do I recommend? I recommend running to all of my swimming students. You've got to do running. You've got to walk, jog, whatever it takes. Just develop your heart rate. Sweat outside on dry land. And then when you go into the water, you will feel the difference. Like, if I don't run and then I go in the pool, I'm gonna feel a lot more sluggish. That's a fact. Because my cardio is all based on water now. It's not based on the running that I do or the amount of jump rope that I do. A lot of these swimmers, you look at them, they're pretty fat, they're overweight, and I ask them, what are you guys eating? What are you eating at the end of every swim session? Burgers, pizza, fries, all that junk. No, you gotta eat clean. Drink green juice like I do, drink protein shakes like I do. Eat chicken breast, vegetables, water, coconut water. You gotta eat clean, man. All of that stuff is just gonna hinder your performance. And you're asking me, after you've done all these things, why you're still like lacking, like why you're still slow, why you can't complete more than one lap or two laps in the pool? Well, it's because you haven't looked at your other areas, such as your diet and your cardio. And these are the two main weaknesses that a lot of swimmers have. Technique is the first thing. We all, as beginners, have struggled with the technique, okay? It's so hard to learn how to breathe, pull with our arms, and kick. But after that, there are two other areas, like I keep saying in this video, that a lot of swimmers neglect. What type of swimmer does all three of these things? Competitive swimmers, okay? Competitive swimmers, they all train at the gym and they all do cardio outside of the pool. And they eat clean. I mean, there is no magic pill. Yes, it takes a lot of hard work. It takes a lot of sessions in the water, but it doesn't end there. No, that's just the beginning. That's the tip of the iceberg when it comes to your training, man. Yeah, it's a battle. It's an uphill battle. But if you really want to like swim forever nonstop, like I do, or like all of these great athletes do, then these are the things you need to consider, okay? Your diet, strength training, and your cardio. And if you need help with these three areas, just subscribe to this YouTube channel, stay tuned for more videos, and I'll show you how to do these three areas. I've shown you in past videos what I do. So take a look at those videos if you want. If you want to get ready for summer, this is the channel to watch, pay attention to, okay? So stay tuned, I got a lot of stuff in the works for you guys, okay? I'm gonna help you with your running, that's for sure. I'm gonna help you with your diet. I'm gonna help you with your strength training. If you wanna be a swimmer, or if you don't wanna be a swimmer, if you just wanna get fit and you just want six-pack abs, this is the channel to watch, no brainer. If you really wanna learn how to swim, visit my website, 7dayswim.co, click the link below. It's the online course that teaches you how to swim from A to Z. And I have like thousands of students enrolled in that course. And join our private Facebook group as well. Down below, network with over 3,000 swimmers from around the world. Ask questions. Whatever help you need with your swimming, we're there to answer your questions for free. So you have the tools to get you started. You have no excuse but to get off your ass, turn off this computer, and get in the water, okay? So do it now. My name's Justin. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.